Assalamualaikum students, today we are going to learn momentum in our unit of dynamics. So what is momentum and in momentum which axioms we are going to study is define momentum, explain the relationship between force and momentum, solve the word problems and state the law of conservation of momentum. So first is what is momentum? And then we are going to study we are going to define momentum. So you must have heard the commentary of the football game or the hockey game. The commentator usually use the word, this momentum word is usually used in the sports, that is the team is gaining the momentum. When we say it is gaining the momentum, it means it is very difficult to stop them. So it is hard to stop them. So the momentum is defined, can be defined as mass in motion, and all the objects have the mass. So the momentum, so is the momentum. So it has mass in motion. The amount of momentum that an object has depends on the two variables: how much stuff is moving and how fast the stuff is moving. So when we say how much stuff is moving, it means it's the mass of the object, and how fast the stuff is moving, again, it is velocity. So momentum depends upon mass and velocity. So quantitatively, it is defined as the quantity of motion present in the body, and it is measured by mass into velocity. As mass is a scalar quantity, but velocity is a vector quantity. So momentum is also a vector quantity. SI unit and formula for the momentum. Momentum is mass into velocity. So formula will be this momentum is equal to m into v, and the unit will be for mass it is kilograms, and for v meter per second. Or we can also say in term of newtons, it is newton second. Suppose that the two friends are running in the playground. One is heavier than the other, but they are moving with the same velocity. Sami weighs 30 kilograms and Ali weighs 40 kilograms. And they're moving with the same velocity. Who has more momentum and why? And who will get hurt more if they hit a wall? So what do you think? Because momentum, because their speed is the same, it means that there are difference in the mass only. So which one has the greater mass? Ali has the greater mass, so Ali has more momentum because its mass is greater than the Sami mass. And then who will get hurt more if they hit a wall? Obviously, it must be Ali again, as the Ali's mass is more than the Sami mass. Ali is hard to stop, so he will get hurt more, as Sami will stop much quickly and easier than Ali. Okay, there is a numerical problem. If a 5 kilogram mass has a velocity of 8 meters in the direction of east to 20 meter per second east, find the object's change in momentum. So what is given in this numerical? Mass of the object is 5 kilogram. Its initial velocity is 8, and when the force is applied, its final velocity becomes 2 meters. So we had to find the whatever is the change in momentum. So change in momentum is represented by this delta P, and the formula will become P is equal to M into delta V. So the solution will be, you are going to put mass is 5 kilograms, initial is final velocity is equal to 2, and initial velocity is 8. So this will be minus 6, minus 6 into 5 is minus 30 kilograms in the direction of east. So it will be plus 30 kilograms in the direction of west. So what is the relationship between the force and momentum? Consider the body of mass is initially moving with a velocity u. The momentum will be given by mass into its velocity mu. If the force acts on the body and causes its acceleration to change, so its final velocity will become v. So the new momentum will be mv. If we are going to find the change in momentum, so that is delta p is equal to final momentum minus the initial momentum. So we are going to write, for instead of delta p, I can write mass into change in velocity. Final momentum is mv and initial momentum is mu. M is taken common, so we are left with u minus v minus u. If we need to find the rate of change in momentum, so we are going to divide the both sides by t. So rate of change of momentum will become m is equal to v minus q final minus initial velocity upon t. Now this become equation one. Now we, according to the second law of motion, we know f is equal to ma and a is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity upon t, means that a is equal to delta v upon t. So this is my, if I put the value of a in this equation, it will become m u minus v by t. So this is my equation two. If I compare equation two, m v f upon t, to equation one, so the equation one is, you can see that again m u minus v upon t, so that you can see equation one and two. If I compare them, I can conclude that rate of change of momentum is equal to f, since f is, this is the same as delta p by t. So but the relation between force and momentum is that the rate of change in momentum is equal to force, or I can write F is equal to m. Okay, now numericals related to that, how long would it take for a net upward force of 100 newton to increase the speed of a 50 kilogram object from 100 to 150? So what is given is that object force is, we have to give a 100 newton of an upward force, and the mass of the object is 50 kilograms, and its initial velocity is 100 and its final velocity is 150. So we need to find the time required. We need to find the time just to change its moment, speed from 100 to 150. So you can apply the formula, F is equal to ma, and a is equal to vf final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. Now this is again the same as the rate of change of momentum. So we can either apply rate of change of momentum, or we can do this equation like this, because rate of change of momentum is equal to force. So solution will be F is equal to m vf minus vi upon t. For substituting the value, 100 is equal to 50, 150 minus 100 upon t. You can take 50 to your left hand side. So 100 upon 50 is equal to t, and you can also take 2 t to the left hand side, so that will become 2t. 150 minus 100 is 50. So 25 divided by 2 is equal, 50 divided by 2 is equal to 25 seconds. So it takes 25 seconds to increase the speed of a 50 kilogram object from 100 to 150 150 meters per second. Now there another question. A 1 kilogram ball traveling at the speed of 4 meters per second strikes a ball and bounces straight back with the speed of 2 meters per second. Find the change in momentum. ओके नाउ व्हाट इज गिवन इज दैट द मास ऑफ द बॉल इज 1 किलोग्राम मूविंग एट द स्पीड ऑफ 4 मीटर पर सेकेंड एंड आफ्टर स्ट्राइकिंग इट बाउंसेस बैक एट -2 मीटर पर सेकेंड इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन सो माइनस साइन इज गिवन नाउ रिक्वायर्ड इज ओनली द चेंज इन मोमेंटम सो द चेंज इन मोमेंटम व्हेन इट इज स्ट्राइकिंग इज इक्वल टू यू कैन से एम इंटू वी वन and m into vf so m is taken common 1 kilogram minus vf minus vi so this will be minus 6 kilograms meter per second or newtons second so delta p so the change in momentum is equal to minus 6 kilogram meter per second at the ball after striking the wall bounces back. Okay, now next is state the law of conservation of momentum. As you can see that in this system, there are three balls. After when they are bouncing back, they go in the different direction and they have the different speeds. But the law of conservation of momentum says in a closed system, when the two bodies interact, the sum of their momentum before the interaction equals the sum of momentum after interaction. Means that when the balls are in this situation, like this, it means that when and they bounces back. So their all their initial moment, before bouncing their momentum is equal to same as the after bouncing so this is your law of conservation of momentum says and this cradle you can see that again the momentum is conserved so you can say by formula total momentum before interaction is equal to total momentum after interaction and you can write m1 u1 is plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 where m1 are the mass of the one object m2 is the mass of another object and u1 is the their velocity before u1 and u2 are the their velocity respective velocities before interaction and v1 and v2 are their velocities that is after interaction like this This is before interaction and that is after interaction. So this is all about the momentum. We are going to continue momentum more SLOs in the next coming topic. So you must learn those before we start the next topic. Thank you so much.